Push me forward and get your feet in alignment with the mat. Heels to heel. Okay? Perfect. Now, turn the front foot forward. Now, on the back foot, turn it inwards, pivot and turn it outwards. If you're too wide, it's not good. Okay? Now is another way to get into warrior one. Means that straight away the back leg has to really work you through that. Mm-hmm. It's kind of more advanced, okay? And it requires quite a lot of opening in the hips.
Is your back heel on the edge of the mat, or is it slightly out?
No, it's slightly out. Slightly out. Slightly out. Okay? So you're moving that front groin inwards and you're grabbing this inner leg, grab it internally. Mm-hmm. That's it. Remember, the inner semitendinosus and the back leg are doing the way. You're flushing these muscles backwards, okay, as much as you can. It's going to take the ribs inwards, okay? And if you, can you see that? It's going to take the ribs inwards. So you're growing taller from that. And then your rib cage inwards are supporting the shoulders. So you have the shoulder blades to go down, okay? And then you start bending the knee without losing the back foot. You start bending the knee more without losing the back foot. Can you feel a difference in that?
Yeah.
Massive, but again, it requires quite a lot of control there. And what you have to do, okay, keep turning forward, not your sternum. The movement happens from here. Mm-hmm. If your hips are not moving, point is moving the sternum too much, okay? Mm-hmm. Now, ribs, shoulders, gaze. Can we have the little baby? Can we have the little baby there? Okay? Now, as you come coming inside that muscle there, lift the front of the sternum more. Now, can you feel my finger? Mm-hmm. Create a space in here by making the knee bending more and the hip coming backwards more. That's beautiful. Okay? Knee goes forward, hips comes backwards. Wonderful. Okay? Now, can you feel my finger in here? Mm-hmm. Engage this muscle there. A little bit, in breath, come up.